Hello, my name is Dillan Villavisanis. I'm an admission consultant with Solomon Admissions, and today we'll be talking a little bit about BSMD admissions and the application process. So as a brief overview, we will talk about several components of the application and the BSMD process, including academics, as well as the activities section, which makes up a majority of the application. This includes research, clinical shadowing, clinical volunteering, leadership, extracurriculars, awards. We'll also talk about the other components, including letters of recommendation, essays, and some final takeaways. So really, BSMD programs offer early admission or a pipeline or a pathway to medical school straight from high school. So these tend to be highly competitive programs that require exceptional academic and personal records. So typically, these programs allow you at the completion of high school, when you're also applying to regular undergraduate schools, to apply to the School of Medicine at the same time. Depending on the program, you will either have a guaranteed or an essentially guaranteed spot in medical school once you complete the undergraduate requirements set out by that particular program. And so it's important to note that as we have this conversation, each program's requirements and pathway are highly individualized. Each one has slightly different requirements or components, both in terms of the application and in terms of your undergraduate performance or requirements that you must complete prior to matriculating to medical school. So I think firstly, a very important component of this application process is the academic component. Now, these programs tend to have highly competitive admission process that is on par with top 10 regular undergraduate schools, if not more competitive. And so what does this look like? Well, first of all, they certainly look at your GPA and your coursework. So, you know, typically students will have near perfect academic records in the environment or in the school that they attended for high school. So this tends to look like having a consistent string of A plus range grades in a very competitive mixed course schedule. So typically students will have maximized their opportunities to take advanced level coursework, including AP, IB, honors. It totally depends on the environment that you're in and the school that you attend, but the programs tend to like to see that you've maximized the rigor of the school that you've been in and also achieved the highest grade in those courses. From a standardized testing perspective, the SAT and ACT certainly play a role in this admission process. Typically, again, they are looking for academic excellence and scores that are either above the 1500 range or 33 range on the ACT. And these tend to be pretty balanced scores in typically a single sitting. Now, I will say that not having one of these academic components will not keep you out of these programs, and having these academic components will not get you into these programs. It's just certainly an important component of this application process because you want to demonstrate that you are capable of a highly rigorous course load, which you'll be taking in undergraduate and then again in medical school. And again, these programs are going off of very little data, so they will use the minimum data that they have to make big decisions about applicants from an academic standpoint. So next, we'll talk a little bit about activities. There's a couple different sections that we talk about when we discuss activities that you've done in high school or things that you've contributed to your community. From a BSMD standpoint, many of these important components include research, clinical shadowing, clinical volunteering, leadership, extracurriculars, and awards. Firstly, research. You know, ideally, you'll have one or two research experiences in a field related to clinical medicine or biomedical sciences. And ideally, this is done under a primary investigator who has an MD, MD, PhD, or PhD. So these can be admittedly challenging to identify as a high school student, but there are certain programs that will allow you to have experience in a lab under a mentor. Typically, these are programs that you apply to in the summer. There's several of them, and they change over the course of the year or over the course of years. But these tend to be good experiences that you can have access to as a high school student while allowing you to pursue your own project. In these experiences, you want to aim to contribute to research in a way that helps generate academic products. So things like manuscripts, abstracts, presentations, and posters. And the reason this is important is because you want to be able to demonstrate that you can disseminate your work, that you can discuss it in front of an audience, that you can contextualize the relevance, talk about what you did, what the results are, and what the implications are for the field of research or for that group of patients. And again, you may need to start going for research through a structured summer program, although there may be PIs who will take you on as a high school student. But again, it's highly individualized, and it will depend if there are institutional requirements that you either need to meet in terms of age or coursework before you can begin working there. So another component that's important to the BSMD process is clinical shadowing. And the reason that's important is because they need to know that you understand what it's like to practice as a physician, or at least that you've seen that to a certain extent or enough to know that that's what you want your career to look like as a high schooler, to be able to go all the way through for medical school. So ideally, this is with an MD clinician seeing and treating patients in either an outpatient clinical setting or an inpatient hospital. This could also be a DO if you're applying to BSDO programs. And typically, you want to have 2 to 3 specialties, at least 50 hours each, which is about one, you know, full-time work week. And ideally, you want to have at least one specialty in primary care or primary care related fields. So things like internal medicine, family medicine, pediatrics. Again, you want to demonstrate that you've spent enough time in this environment to fully appreciate what it means to treat patients from this population, the depth and breadth of the condition that the clinician is seeing, and that you can have some patient examples that you can discuss in an interview setting if you're asked about that. Another important component, which is slightly related to clinical shadowing, but I think we think about it pretty distinctly, is clinical volunteering. And so this is really being involved in a multidisciplinary healthcare environment with at least MDs, typically also RNs, patient care technicians, and other clinicians in the healthcare environment who work together in a multidisciplinary fashion to provide care for patients in whatever setting that may be. But again, here you want to have about 100 hours, and that's not a hard and fast rule, but at least 100 hours so that you've seen really what it takes to treat patients in this environment, the type of patients that they're treating, the type of complications, and things to that nature. And again, you want to be able to speak to patient examples in a de-identified fashion in an interview or an essay setting when asked. That way you can kind of substantiate this experience, discuss with the admissions committee what you learned from this, and again, how it's motivated you to pursue a career in medicine. So again, there's a lot of different places that you could pursue an experience like this, including academic hospitals, outpatient centers, medical surgical units, rehabilitation centers. But, you know, the goal really is to be engaging in a multidisciplinary clinician healthcare team, ideally with at least one MD, but certainly many, many other healthcare providers to be able to provide care for patients. So another component of the application that's pretty important for BSMD is leadership broadly. And I tend to think of this outside of just a clinical setting. But this really is leadership in a way that you are driving a cause for something that you care personally about to be able to impact other people. So that sounds very broad, but you know, it can totally depend on what you yourself are interested in, whether that's something that's related to a clinical field in medicine or not. These can be things in healthcare related to healthcare policy, related to healthcare economics, pure clinical medicine, research adjacent, global health, Law. So, you know, it really depends on what your interests are, but I think the key for leadership from a BSMD standpoint is that you have identified an unmet need either in your immediate community or the national community or a global community that you care about and that you have then addressed by building some sort of infrastructure around that. And so, again, that's pretty broad, but we work with you to help identify what you are most interested in and then how you can make an impact in that area. And that's important because the admission committee wants to know that when you come to undergraduate, when you come to medical school, that you have a habit or the ability to identify problems in those environments for both patients in a research setting, et cetera. That way, you have the tools that you need to be able to solve those problems and some sort of previous leadership experience to inform that. So another important component is extracurricular activities. These tend to include hobbies and clubs not described elsewhere in the application. So this is not necessarily leadership. It's not necessarily clinical related, but really think about this like sports, music, performance, hobbies, including things that you would do outside of the context for just applying to medical school. And these are very important component of the application because they demonstrate teamwork, they demonstrate your ability to engage in the community, to give back in a way that's not necessarily just clinical or just academic. But these activities should be ones that you tend to enjoy outside of just applying to undergraduate or just applying to medical school. So these should be things that you hopefully enjoy enough to continue into your career, that serve as a good outlet for you, whether they relate to medicine or not. But the important thing is kind of the skills that you gain from doing these activities and what they mean to you on a personal level. Finally, the last kind of section of the activities component of the application is awards. And these are things that you may not have many awards or any awards starting out in high school, but you tend to accumulate over time. So this includes school level awards like honor roll, national level awards, you know, National Merit Scholarship, AP Scholar Awards, Research Awards, other scholarships, Community Service Awards. So many of these may be garnered at the school level, but I would tend to encourage students to look for opportunities in either their community or elsewhere to be able to identify awards that may help them from an application process. Again, awards are not a required component of the application, but typically by having a strong academic record, students tend to garner awards over time. And then an often overlooked component of the application is letter of recommendation. This is a hugely important part of the BSMD application because you really get to understand the applicant through someone else's eyes who's worked with them in an academic or a professional or a community-based setting. And so typically, the letters of recommendation tend to come from at least one guidance counselor or school official, like a principal, one science teacher, and one other mentor, perhaps a research mentor or a community service leadership type mentor. And again, you want to ask someone who knows you personally. You want to ask someone who's known you for a long enough amount of time and someone who you feel that you've worked with to solve a problem or in an academic setting. And they kind of have an understanding of the way that you work through problems, the way that you work with others, and what your motivation are for a career in medicine. So I think there should, when you're asking for a letter of recommendation, there really should be no question in your mind if this person's going to write a strong letter or not. I think you should make that clear before asking, but you know, you should really be very confident on your relationship with this person and be able to think of specific instances that you worked with this individual to help solve a problem or work through an academic issue or something in a classroom to that nature that they can attest to in a letter. And finally, essays, you know, there are a variety of prompts that are asked by these types of programs. But essentially, you know, through them, you should at least be able to explain or describe your motivation for a career in medicine. Again, this is important because they're taking you as a high school student, you know, 4 or 5 years before they would normally be seeing your application through a regular admission process. So you want to make your motivation for a career in medicine very clear through these essays. You also want to be able to have some kind of description of your future academic plans and goals, even if those are not fully set in stone and they certainly are expected to change over time, at least demonstrating some kind of ability that you can describe your goals or know what type of career you may be interested in at this point based on what you've already done. And then finally, I think you want to convey a sense of humility through your essays. You don't want to be bragging about your accomplishments or simply just reciting your CV, and then a sense of humanity of why you want to treat patients, why this is important to you, why you want to go into this profession to impact other people. So I think in summary, the BSMD program pipeline is a great option for those who know that they want to pursue a career in medicine very early on. These are very highly, highly competitive programs that require a very exceptional academic and personal record at a very young age, and they can be as competitive, if not more competitive, than some of the top 5, top 10 undergraduate schools. And then this just requires very careful planning with several application components. Because there are so many moving parts, you just want to be able to plan ahead accordingly. That way you can fulfill all of the requirements of the BSMD application process, including research, clinical shadowing, clinical volunteering, leadership, et cetera. And that's it from our perspective. Thanks for listening, and feel free to get in touch with us with any questions. Thanks so much.